The acting Minister for Justice and Constitutional Affairs, Muruli Mukasa, today presented a statement on reports of alleged human rights violations by state security operatives, distancing government from condoning torture. The minister says torture is neither a policy of government nor a method of interrogation.
Torture is not a policy of government, nor is it even a method of interrogation. And there is indeed a law about this, and the law is very clear. His Excellency the President has, in his own words, stated this position and policy of government many times. Any security agency, any security agent or operative, or any person who conducts himself or herself in such a manner, i.e. torturing, that person does so in his own or her own personal capacity, and indeed will and shall be handled in accordance with the law.
It's extremely surprising that what happened in Uganda in the 70s, in the 80s, is getting or back into the country. It's very unfortunate that we are seeing a number of Ugandans being tortured, and yet we have the Constitution, Article 44, that states clearly that every human being is equal before the law, but also most importantly, inhuman treatment is prohibited.
Muruli Mukasa promised Parliament a speedy trial for the two incarcerated MPs, Muhammad Segirinya and Alan Sewanyana, saying investigations into the matter were complete and the two have been committed for trial in the High Court of Masaka.
The state carried out the investigations and completed the inquiries. Once the court cause list is out for the cases, the state shall be ready to adduce evidence at the trial. Right, Honorable Speaker?
Recently, you've all seen young one gentleman, a gentleman called Kakwenzi. We cannot keep quiet. Our silence is deafening. And if we fall silent, then where will people run? He was arrested, detained beyond the reasonable hours prescribed by the Constitution, and beaten like you also to the pulp. Up to now, you can see all the marks of him being beaten. What message are we sending out to the country that officers can arrest people and beat them and detain them?
MPs condemn the escalating cases of torture, arbitrary arrests, illegal detention, among others, and asked government to pronounce itself and redeem its image on the matter.
But we are defiling our own constitution. It has provided vehemently against torture of Ugandans. Must we take pride in doing it again and again? Right, Honorable Speaker, this House must come up with a clear guideline on the particular individuals who torture Ugandans in the name of state operatives.
Sometimes the security people torture us even when President Museveni doesn't know. What only makes President Museveni a suspect is when he comes out to say, we don't give bail to the capital offenders. But the security people, stop torturing us. Stop torturing Ugandans. One day, you never know, you'll be out of that chair. What will happen to you?
The Deputy Speaker, Anita Among, directed the minister to stop lamentations and bring to book perpetrators of torture who are still at large.
The errant members, the errant persons who are causing problems to the government must be brought to book. And who makes them do that? Are they above the law? Is there a problem? Do you need help from us? And if you need, then we are here to help you.
I have been here for quite some time. And I have, in my time, experienced raw, palpable torture. However, what is quite consoling is that at least the infrastructure against torture and the will to fight torture is there now.
Anita Among asked the chairperson of the Human Rights Committee to work with the Ministry of Security and other relevant agencies to investigate cases of human rights violations across the country in 45 days.
You work together with the Minister of Security and all their agencies and produce a report to this House.
Now, we don't know whether the members of security forces really obey the commanding chief and the president of the country, because what is happening now, it is damaging public confidence in government and in security forces. It goes against Article 4 of our constitution, which debars anybody from torturing a citizen.
Last week, opposition stormed out of parliament and vowed not to come back for 14 days due to increased cases of torture. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at parliament.